Hello and welcome to another random battle replay cast, and today I'm featuring a ship that is probably not very often seen, to be seen. This is the tier 6 French battleship, the Normandy, which I grind currently on my EU alt account. And yeah, I had a pretty good game. The title says it all. I had kind of a one-man show going on. So first of all, about the Normandy. Well, it's not a particularly great ship, I would say. Yeah, it has 12 340mm guns, which overmatch 23mm of armor, which is okay if you fight against tier 5s and tier 6s, but already at tier 7 you can't overmatch the bows of battleships anymore, and then you are forced to shoot a lot of HE. Obviously, I try to avoid this as much as possible. Tier 8, it's gonna be an HE fest anyways, because the 25mm bows of cruisers will also give you quite a lot of trouble. Apart from that, the guns are okay. Good velocity, good penetration, tend to overpen a lot of the same tier or even over tier cruisers. Dispersion is... Let me quick check. I forgot it a bit. It's 1.6 Sigma, so also not really great, but okay. Playing around a bit here with the in the replay, but okay. Just wanted to look at the ship. I just maybe you noticed. You see the secondaries here in the front. You can just steam ahead and yeah. Let your secondaries work in the front. This is also not too shabby. They won't do much damage, but maybe set the fire. But yeah, I had this game here on Ring, and I hoped to have some support from my team. I also, yeah, I was already worried about the lemming train and so on. So the Stranto gets more or less caught off guard. I'm immediately turning out, and boom! There we go, triple citadel. The Ismail took the chance and backfired, but I got lucky, I assume. Could have hurt me way, way more. Yeah, that's the first kill after not even 3 minutes. Quite nice. Obviously, you start to focus the cruisers first. I have only a 13-point captain, so I'm missing out... how is it called? Fire prevention. So you can get burned down pretty quickly if you don't have this. And so on and so on. I'm playing it very passive, but I have literally not so much support. My team decided, nah, not really. We don't want to. But if you maybe know my stream and so on, I hated to give up flanks easily, and I hate lemming trains with all of my heart. This is just, even though it might work, doesn't care. I'm trying to avoid that. And Tyra, sometimes I'm a bit stubborn and stick to my side here and so on and so on, which is obviously not always recommended, but yeah, I don't give it up easily, let's say it like this. And that's a thing you shouldn't do as well. So if you see a lemming train, maybe try to convince the people to maybe stay with you. Can help sometimes. Sometimes they ignore you. Okay, the Nuremberg is pretty low, so I'm only shooting one gun. Maybe the Ismail takes the chance. That's kill number two. Ismail takes the chance to also dish out on me, but he isn't really. That shot is for the superstructure, which is basically hilarious if you look at the Ismail. So my further plan is, okay, I want to go wide on the flank. Let's see what the Ismail does. So he's ignoring me. That's perfect. If I can get around him, then I can shoot the New Mexico. And as long as he doesn't pay attention, I don't have to deal with him. That's basically my plan. The Normandy is probably the fastest battleship among the normal tech tree ships, I think. With 30 knots or 29.5, something around. Taking a pot shot on New Mexico. That's that mobility you can use to your advantage. On the other hand, your concealment is pretty shite. You have 14.1 with concealment expert. which brings you at a point where you are going to snipe. And you have actually the range to for it, 19.8. That's pretty okay. I'm getting shot here from every directions, but now I'm angling in. He's still not paying attention, so I'm taking another pot shot on the New Mexico who shot me, so I'm turning still full in. Turret traverse is also pretty garbage. I don't know if I have expert marksman, I don't think so. Or, oh well, I think I have actually. Yeah, and it's still pretty shit. And turret layout, well, for Prawls, this is not a ship made for Prawls. Your back turret will never be able to. Or if you do that, you show so much broadside that you get completely annihilated. So my plan, obviously Ismail has a pretty vulnerable citadel, but the first two turrets you can use to your advantage. Okay, that was expected. I think the Normandy has also a turtle back. So I'm slowing down, swing my front and middle turret to the other side. Just to basically don't move my ship too much. I have my guns reloaded before because I shot first. And citadel, citadel, boom, dead. Well, and this develops more or less to a one-man show. If you look where my team is, well, they are not even close around. Yeah, nowhere to be seen. Next one on the list is the König. Usually a good CV player, you maybe noticed there's a CV in the game. A good CV player is just, yeah, focusing you. But I saw an opportunity here to wipe out this flank, more or less, if the enemy does mistakes. If not, well, then I try to trade as good as I can. That's always my goal here. And this König makes a lot of mistakes. I'm angling in, so he's shooting my armor belt and not my bow, because the bow armor is... should be at 19 or so on this tier. I'm not 100% sure. But yeah, I try to, of course, mitigate the damage. Here I show a bit too much broadside. But since I can shoot my back turret as well and he's still sailing full broadside, well, I can even capitalize on it. I was a bit slow here on the turning in. A bit sloppy of me, but I mean, I just do exactly the same with the König. What I did basically with the Ismail. Just swinging my front turrets. And here I used my armor belt, angled enough, and I baited him to shoot him. I guess he doesn't know, which is absolutely fine on this tier. Of course, I'm capitalizing a bit on my experience here, but I also don't want to self-congratulate myself too much in this video, but it was actually a one-man show. My team didn't help me too much here. So I'm turning in again, present my belt armor. So he's shooting that and not my bow. Exactly, he did that. So now I can turn out because he doesn't have any bullets in his or any shells in his guns anymore. Ah, okay. I guess I wasn't that sure, so I'm just relying on my middle turret. And finish the König off as well. So, that's four ships down. Completely cleared this flank. Yeah, more or less without my team. I even asked for support, but nobody felt like that's a good idea. Of course, the cruisers had to kite when the battleships pushed in like this. Understandable. But still, I was a bit pissed. I mean, if that game would have gone a bit different, so our other side wouldn't have won their flank, I could have been up against their whole team and I had literally no support. And that's always a bit disgusting, but people play too passive or they play absolutely yeah, crazy aggressive. Alright, so yeah, I'm intending to continue my path here in that regard. So let's see if I can secure my Kraken. And Molotov is pretty slow because he's flooding. Maybe I can get some hits in. Two overpens. two more shots. At this point, it's all about getting damage done, because the game is basically won. Only one penetration, so I want to make this shot count. And shot a bit early again. I don't know what he's doing here right now, but I think he wants to stop. Okay, in this case I sequential fire because I really want to secure this kill, but first salvo was enough. And that's my Kraken secured. Runs pretty smooth, right? But I had two games before where I had to struggle so hard in this ship. I think two games before I made already a Kraken, lost the game. The game afterwards I lost as well, like again with 100k or 110k against tier 10 against tier 6 opponents, so the same tier, but my team died. I couldn't do too much, and then the time ran out, and yeah, the usual stuff that we all know, right? Yeah, and hello, Mr. Trento. Is that the next Italian on my list? It looks pretty much like it. Bing! Another Citadel, so that we count 7. And there's still a juicy carrier, so can we make it 7 kills? That's the big question here. I mean, I have the range, the shell velocity, penetration. If I can get maybe some good salvos out. Problem is he's vanishing every now and then. Means it's gonna be problematic to see if I hit correctly or not. Is he fast? Is he not so fast? I think he's going full speed, so I'm aiming a bit in front. A bit higher, and yeah, let's see if I can actually citadel him. That would be, of course, the icing on the cake if I could take out the carrier as well, but time is running out. Carrier noticed me now, but now it's obviously too late. I don't really care about him. 978. Another salvo out, and I can't still see where my shells land. And only 2 overpens, but I'll take it. A good game is always a thing that you like to have. So ended up 154k even damage, 70 hits. Well, let's be honest. I mean, as I said, I don't want to self-congratulate a bit, but even it's possible in every ship that you can perform quite good, as I did here in the Normandy. Even though I would consider it among the weaker tier 6 battleships, and I capitalized probably on the inexperience of my opponents or whatever, casual players, they didn't care. But yeah, for me it was quite satisfying to have, after 2 losses that were quite horrible, where I also performed well, that I finally had a success here. Base XP wise, 2000 as top tier, definitely I'll take that. This is a pretty good result. Pretty hard to get like more than 2000 if you're top tier. I mean, I killed 6 ships. The only thing I was missing out is Confederate, because I didn't damage 6 ships by 20%. I think that's what you need to do. So that's the only achievement that was missing, and I think fireproof as well. Oh, there was not much HE spam, right? I think I had 1.5 million potential. Let's see. Yeah, you see it here. That's also quite a bit. Exclusively shot AP. In these matchups, you should do it. And only if the enemy is completely angling all the time, then you can, or it's like stalemate and a pretty rough game where you have some opponents that know what they are doing. I mean, for example, bow on Ismails, what are you gonna do? I mean, you have to shoot the upper part of the nose. And yeah, with 1.6 Sigma dispersion, it's quite hard to achieve that. Also Fuso, so they are all pretty tanky battleships on this tier. I mean, New Mexico, Queen Elizabeth, Warspite, Arizona and so on, you can pen almost everywhere if you shoot the superstructure and so on. But yeah, Ismail and Fuso in in that regard are different. So occasionally I tend to switch to AG in these cases. All right, yeah, just wanted to show you that. Hope you enjoyed it. Enjoyed this one-man show. Apart from that, I wish you a good day as usual. And yeah, give it a like if you liked it, and maybe share it or push the subscribe button. I always up for this. Bye-bye and see you next time.